Hello students, we are in the second chapter of geography. The name of the chapter is known as The Structure of Earth. I am Sam Sir. This is our beautiful blue planet Earth. Do you know how old it is? It is estimated that it is 5 billion years old. Now we are going to see what is there inside the Earth. The scientists who study the interior of the Earth in detail are known as geologists. Our Earth we assume to be a perfect sphere, but it is not a perfect sphere. It is something known as geoid, which I'll show you in the next slide. And the diameter of the Earth is exactly 12,742.6 kilometers. And the radius we take as an approximation, and also written in your textbook, is taken as 6,400 kilometers. Now this is close to what our Earth actually looks like. This is a geoid or the spheroid shape. We can compare the interior of the Earth with a fruit, let us say a peach or a plum or a mango. The outer skin is equivalent to the crust of the Earth. The pulp that we eat is comparable to the mantle of the Earth, and the seed or the stone, as some call it, is comparable to the core of the Earth. Now if we were to cut a section from our fruit or from our Earth, we can see this three layers crust, which is 5 kilometers thick in the oceanic areas and 35 kilometers thick in the continental areas. The mantle is about 2,900 kilometers thick, and the core is having a radius of 3,500 kilometers. This is a view of all the layers of Earth. The crust is the thinnest layer of Earth. We also call it as the lithosphere. There are two types of crust. One is the continental, that is below the landmass, and the other one is oceanic, that is below the ocean. When we look at the composition of the continental crust, it is mainly made up of silica and alumina, and in short we say Sial. In Sial, Si comes from silica and Al comes from alumina. In the oceanic crust, the major elements are silica and magnesium, so we call it Sima. In Sima, Si comes from silica and Ma comes from magnesium. Now, therefore, the three major elements in the crust of the Earth are silica, aluminium, and magnesium. Please note that the scientific representation for silica is Si, for aluminium it is Al, and for magnesium it is Mg. The outer crust has got the layer of soil on which we live and grow our crops. Now, if you look at this picture, This is a diagrammatic view of the crust. On the left hand side you have the continental crust made up of Sial, and it is about 35 kilometers thick. The area below the ocean is known as the oceanic crust, and it is anywhere between 5 kilometers and 8 kilometers thick. This is known as Sima because of silica and magnesium. Below the crust is the layer known as mantle. This is made up of heavy materials such as magnesium, iron, and silica. It has got two distinct layers. The distinction comes from the temperature. The upper layer is much colder at 890 degrees Celsius, but it is still very hot. And the lower layer is known as lower mantle, and it has got a temperature of 2400 degrees Celsius. Now, at this high temperature, even magnesium, silica, iron, or even rocks are there in molten state or in melted form or in liquid form. That liquid form of rock is known as magma, and it is found in the lower mantle. Now lava is the magma which has come out. If there's a volcanic eruption, then the magma comes out, and after that magma has come out of the volcano, it is known as lava. And now this lava is naturally then rich in metals and minerals. This is what the lava looks like when it is flowing out of a volcano. And this is a picture of a volcano erupting. And you can see lava flowing down from the sides of the volcano. The innermost part of the earth is known as the core, and it is situated below the mantle. It is made up of heavy metals such as nickel and iron. Now the scientific notation for nickel is Ni, and for iron it is Fe. Fe stands for ferrum, which is the Latin name of iron. Now both of them are metals, and at such high temperatures both are in the molten form. Now the core also has got two layers. The outer core has got a temperature much less than the inner core, and that is at 2200 degrees Celsius. The inner core's temperature is 5000 degrees Celsius. Now we are going to study about rocks and minerals. The scientific study of rocks is known as petrology. The material that formed the crust is called the rock. Now these rocks are made up of minerals, but these rocks do not have any fixed composition of the minerals. Now rocks can have different physical properties. Some are very hard, some are soft. Some have different composition, some are very hard, and the color may also be different. Minerals are natural substances found in the earth's crust. They contain one or more elements. They have a definite chemical composition and physical properties. They may be metallic or non-metallic. The examples of metallic minerals are iron, gold, copper, silver, etc. And non-metallic are silica, carbon, etc. Now, the minerals vary in color and texture, hardness and luster. Now, they are useful for various activities on Earth. For example, they are good fuels. Coal, natural gas and petroleum are the examples of fuels. They are useful in the factories, in industries. Iron and aluminium are important for us. They are used in medicines also. Rock phosphate is used in fertilizers. Also potash is used in fertilizers. Ores are rocks in which a particular mineral is found in a larger percentage. For example, we have ore for copper, we have ore for iron, etc. Now, wherever there's ores are formed, the process of taking it out from the earth is known as mining. And after mining is done, it is purified and the metals are obtained. Types of rocks. Now, on the basis of their formation, rocks are classified into three types: igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic. Igneous rocks are formed by the cooling of the molten magma. They are also known as primary rocks because they were the first to be formed. As soon as the molten magma comes out, it forms a solid mass and a hard mass. That is the igneous rock. Now, igneous rock can be of two types. They can be intrusive or extrusive. The difference is, if the magma cools down below the surface of the earth, it is known as intrusive rock. But if the magma cools down after reaching the surface of the earth or after coming out from the crust, it is known as extrusive igneous rock. And it takes thousands of years for formation of large crystals of rocks in igneous, intrusive igneous. In extrusive igneous, they cool rapidly because they reach the atmosphere and it's much colder there. So they are fine grained. Lava that comes out cools down quickly, so crystals are not very large. Intrusive igneous rocks are hard and compact, but the extrusive igneous rocks are not as hard as the intrusive igneous rocks. The examples of intrusive igneous rocks are granite and dolerite. Many of you might have seen, you might have the flooring made up of granite in your house. The example of extrusive igneous is basalt and obsidian. Basalt is a common stone that you find outside your house. Here are some pictures: granite cut in the form of tiles, and basalt and obsidian. The characteristics of igneous rocks are, fossils are not found in igneous rocks. The reason is, because at such high temperatures, if any plant or animal material goes inside the below the surface of earth, it will burn. It will get converted into ashes. These rocks do not form strata or layers. Metals and minerals like silver, gold, and iron and copper are found in these rocks. And these rocks are waterproof. They do not allow water to percolate through them. Now, sedimentary rocks. These are because of rolling and cracking of rocks and by action of wind, water, moving ice, as in glaciers, plants, and animals, rocks break down into small fragments. Now, these small fragments of rock get carried away by wind and river. They get deposited in layers in lowlands, lakes, and ocean beds. There, over a period of thousands of years, they harden and form sedimentary rocks. Now, example of sedimentary rocks are sandstone that people use in Rajasthan for making steps outside their houses or the frames for the doors and windows. Then, limestone is again a sedimentary rock. Shale, chalk, and conglomerate are all sedimentary rocks. Here are some for you. On the left-hand side is the familiar sandstone, and on the right-hand side is the shale. Now, specialities of sedimentary rocks are, these rocks are made up of particles of various sizes. They are found mostly underwater and have marks of waves and mud cracks. They are formed in horizontal layers. They are softer than igneous rocks. Fossils are sometimes found between the layers, and fossil fuels are also obtained from these rocks. Here's a picture of a fossil of a fish from sandstone, which is a sedimentary rock. The third type of rock in your textbook is a metamorphic rock. Sedimentary and igneous rocks change their form under very high pressure and temperature. The pressure will be because of the weight of soil on earth, on the crust, and the temperature is because of the high temperature in the mantle. Now, this changes the rocks into something else. The physical characteristics are changed. Such changed rocks are known as metamorphic rocks. And it's a slow process. It takes thousands of years for them to be formed. And marble, gneiss, slate, and quartzite are some examples. See here, the left is a limestone. And after it goes through that process, it will convert into marble or Sangmarmar. Similarly, granite will turn into gneiss. Shale will turn into slate. Both have a flat structure to start with. Sandstone can also, if the conditions are different, turn into quartzite. Now, this is very familiar for you. Coal is a familiar mineral for you. And the pencil you hold in your hand has got the writing tip made up of graphite. About graphite you have learned in science last year. Now, coal, when it undergoes this process of high temperature and high pressure over a long period of time, will convert into diamond. Both are carbon. Coal is also carbon. Graphite is also carbon and diamond is also carbon, but the forms are different. Now, the characteristics of metamorphic rocks. First of all, they are very hard and have a closed banded structure. Bands may be present, as in case of marble. If you have marble flooring, just look, have a good look at it. You'll find lines of gray color or dark color in that. And the example of hardness is, diamond is one of the hardest substances known to man. These metamorphic rocks are heavy. That is, they have very high specific gravity. Specific gravity of water is taken to be as 1. That means 1 liter water will weigh 1 kilogram. And we compare many substances, whether it is liquid or gases, or liquids and solids, to the specific gravity of water. And that way, we find that the metamorphic rocks are very heavy. These rocks do not have empty spaces in them because of the pressure and high temperature under which they form. These rocks are very stable in their composition because they have already undergone the process of high pressure and high temperature. Now, uses of rocks and minerals, they are used for construction mainly, whether it is houses, roads or buildings. Soil is formed from rocks because of weathering and erosion. Chemicals obtained from sedimentary rocks are used for making fertilizer. Rock phosphate and potash are the examples of this. Coal and petroleum provide power. Both are a type of mineral and it's extracted from sedimentary rocks. Rocks were used in ancient times to make tools and weapons. Now, just like you have read about the water cycle last year, we have something similar known as rock cycle. This is a process in which one type of rock is changed into another type in a cyclic manner. And it is a continuous process. It's a slow process, but it's a continuous process. If you look at a piece of rock outside your house, it doesn't appear to us that it's changing into something else. But given a period of several hundred thousand years, it will change into something else. Rocks get destroyed and formed again. This is happening in the rock cycle. Rocks undergo breaking by erosion, deposition, pressure, melting and cooling, and this changes them. Igneous rocks are formed when hot magma cools down. Now, these igneous rocks break down due to several factors. When they form deposits, it leads to the formation of sedimentary rock. So here you can see that igneous rock has changed into sedimentary rock. Now, sedimentary rock and igneous rock both change into metamorphic rocks under high temperature and high pressure, just like we have seen about the formation of metamorphic rocks. Now, here's a diagrammatic representation. You have this number one igneous rock, which breaks down into fragments, and these fragments get deposited by activity of water and convert into sedimentary rock. And this sedimentary rock undergoes pressure, high pressure and high temperature changing process, and it changes into metamorphic rock. They again go back to the mantle where they again change into igneous rock, and this cycle continues. This is the end of the chapter, and the picture here is of Johannesburg, and it is the biggest, deepest mine on earth, and this mine is for diamond and it is 4 kilometers deep. You have learned that the crust of earth is 35 kilometers deep. We cannot keep on digging and going deeper and deeper because it's very hot inside, apart from the challenges. So with this we come to the end of this chapter. I hope it is beneficial for your studies. Even if you give it a thumbs down, it doesn't matter, because the purpose of this chapter is not to get a liking from you. But if you like it, that's so nice of you. I'm not a YouTuber, I'm a school teacher. Bye till we meet in the next chapter.